I had to make sure I was here on time today just to see McGuire.
We're from out of town, from Baton Rouge, and we really wanted to come see him play because we really think this is the year that he's going to do it, break that record.
We've always been Cardinal fans, but now they got him. We've got to be here to see batting practice for sure.
My husband says he's the best. I don't know. I've never gotten here so early, so it's going to be an experience.
Every so many years, a person comes along that's just so far above and beyond everyone else that you just can't pass up an opportunity. It's a must-see.
Okay, guys, please do not run.
I've followed him pretty closely throughout the year, and it's been exciting. And like I say, you know, it's his first time to Houston. I couldn't miss a chance to get out here and see him play.
Mr. McGuire, please.
I think most of the people are out here to see him. That's basically why we got our tickets, really.
The only reason that I'm here tonight is specifically to see the best home run hitter in baseball and probably the best in my lifetime.
Hopefully he's going to hit some home runs over here.
And I'll tell you what, I think there's a lot of people that would like to be able to catch one.
Man, we're pretty, you know, far out here, man. He's killing the ball. That's incredible. I just come to see history in the making, man. I brought my little son, got lucky and caught a baseball for him.
That's well hit down the line at left, and gone. One pitch. There it goes. Mark McGuire has hit another one. Upper deck to left center field. One of the longest home runs ever hit here.
Pretty sweet. That's one at the ballpark at Arlington this year, and now one here.
You ought to see the hand of the guy that it bounced off of.
Yeah.
It's almost kind of like Michael Jordan. You know, you want to go see him because he's the greatest player that ever played basketball. And you're rooting for your home team, but still, you want to go for excitement. That's what Mark McGuire provides.
Batting practice, and they watched him tonight. Now just watch this. Admittedly, it's BP. This one is going to go clean out of the ballpark, over the pavilion roof, and out into the parking lot. That's one. The next time, he didn't get all of it. This one instead bounces on the roof and goes out. And for good measure, he tries his luck to left of the center field flagpoles and hits it three quarters of the way up.
Big Mac a signé des autographes pendant plusieurs minutes avant de donner son spectacle lors de la pratique au bâton. McGuire a frappé plusieurs circuits et il a presque sorti la balle du stade à deux reprises, au grand plaisir des spectateurs et même de quelques journalistes.
This was about an hour ago. Mac, you're looking almost from center field. And this is the McGuire swing. It appears almost one-handed and it went out about 450 feet. Easy for you, very difficult for me, said.
Tour dans la cage des frappeurs, mais on l'a vu entre autres à Washington avoir plus de succès. Mais on a frappé quand même deux très loin lors de la première ronde de la pratique au bâton, dont une par-dessus les estrades populaires au champ gauche qu'on vient de voir, et ensuite une très loin au champ centre. L'an dernier, McGuire avait frappé un circuit lors
de. At the batting cage, it only means one thing, Big Mac. At the dish in batting practice, and this one is deep. Fifth deck, upper deck, whatever you want to call it, at Bush. Rare a fight hit.
He headed for serious trouble as Mark McGuire, Sammy Sosa, they did put on a show in BP before today's ball game, launching shot after shot onto Waveland Avenue and down Kenmore Street here on Chicago's north side. And the wind continues to whistle out toward the left.
And earlier today, the crowds out in Waveland got plenty of souvenirs. Sammy Sosa hit four completely out of Wrigley Field, much to the delight of the hometown fans, and the one fellow who made a great catch. But then Mark McGuire, as he did most of last year, upstaged Slammin' Sammy. McGuire hit seven out onto Waveland Avenue, one even beyond Waveland Avenue. As McGuire continues to be a great show just in batting practice all by himself.
Protecteur spécial à la jambe. Alors, il a été blessé en plusieurs occasions. I'm a place to be, especially when Mark McGuire has taken some hacks like this. He's taken some hacks before the Cards-Giants game. Man, launches the moonbeam there up to the upper deck. That impressed some observers. That's Jack Buck right there.
Today they were dancing in the streets, quite literally, as Big Mac took batting practice around 12:30 Central Time. He launched eight or nine more shots into the street, and, well, the fans were, well, they didn't mind the buses, but they were really battling for the old souvenir. Another awesome display by Mark McGuire, who got a standing ovation for BP again here at Wrigley Field. Cardinal fans and Cub fans alike watching Big Mac.
Come on, Big Boy!
He is the strong man at the carnival, and everyone wants to catch his act. Even if it's just practice.
We're too low. They're all going over our heads.
We're driving 540 miles to see McGuire, and he's going to knock one out 540 feet.
They almost broke our scoreboard. He hit a ball off the scoreboard in deep left field. If you've been to the ballpark, you know where Oakland is on the scoreboard. You see that damage just to the right of it? What a blast.
It drew a few oohs and ahs from the fans that were assembled out there. He hit another one just to the left of that on the framework next to the Southern Company sign, almost up there by the cannons, the Coca-Cola cannons.
That really takes away from what baseball is all about, I think. I know the fans are excited about it, and I'm happy they're coming to watch me take batting practice. But there's other great players on the team that take batting practice, too.
What are you trying to do to prepare yourself for the game?
Exactly what I'm doing in the game. You know, Dave McKay is probably one of the best BP throwers I've had my whole career. And he just doesn't throw out there to groove it for me. He usually works me pretty good.
New Mark McGuire exercise video. All right. Whip that leg. Whip that leg. Here we go. One, two. One, two. A new Mark McGuire exercise video here. Exclusive of Hometown Cable. Feel the burn there, Mark. Although we were told he wasn't starting, McGuire's out there at first base, where he has been the last two nights. Feeling the batted ball, so I'm sure if he told the manager, Tony La Russa, where'd he go? La Russa was here a moment ago. That he wanted in, that he would insert him, but as far as we know, Big Mac will not be in the lineup tonight, but he's out there at first base at his position, feeling the grounders at this point. Eric Davis just made a friend for life. He just handed a bat up into the stands to one of these kids. He's walking back, looking around. Maybe it's a cracked bat. He was looking around, looking for a likely recipient, and walked towards the dugout and handed the bat up into the bleachers. So whoever that kid was, he's going to be a lifetime fan of Mr. Eric Davis, number 24, out there. One thing Mark McGuire has been good about is signing autographs. He's chosen a different area this time. He's down the third baseline. He's been very cooperative, I think, as far as autograph signing. Obviously, he can't sign 20,000 autographs in a night. I think if he could, he he'd sign till the people stopped asking him for it. He'd end up signing his name 20,000 times because a lot of people would go through the line twice. But he has been very good about seeking out the youngsters and signing whatever he can. On the field, and he's going to be doing a pregame interview.
These are probably Cardinal announcers. They don't look familiar, so they're probably with the St. Louis Cardinals. Looks very relaxed. The last time he was here, the end of April, first 2 days in May, April 30th, May 1st, May 2nd. He wasn't doing much talking. He was in a mini slump at that point. Wasn't doing that well at the plate and didn't talk to anybody while here in Montreal. Hopefully today he'll be in a more congenial mood. We're hoping to get hometown cable coverage here all 3 days. I'll be back here tomorrow along with Foxy Gagnon and Foxy's son Eric. And then on Wednesday, the 25th, we're hoping that maybe Peter Regner can find his way up here and give us hometown cable coverage of all 3 days of Mark McGuire here in Montreal. Because we were here for all 3 days back in April 30th, May 1st, May 2nd, in that trip. Only two trips to Montreal for the Cardinals. The Cubs only came to town one time. It's now after 5 p.m., so the doors have been opened and the fans have made their way in here. And they usually gather right around this area where the players come out, right by the Cardinal dugout, or the visitor's dugout. It's Cardinal's dugout today. And you'll find a lot of people with red shirts on, red hats, and wearing, what number is that guy wearing anyway? What's his number? 25, Mark McGuire. You'll find a few of those shirts around, even though we're in Olympic Stadium and we're supposed to be here cheering for the Expos.
I'm just trying to protect my balls. It's all good.
See the ball?
Pressure is walking out of your door, you know, every day. This is what I love to do, and I do it, you know, every day.
It means I've been consistent. I've worked very, very hard at what I'm doing. I've improved my game, my swing. I've always hit home runs ever since I was a little kid. I'm just, you know, a lot smarter hitter, very patient hitter, and put those things together. And start playing 150 to 155 games a year. I just ask myself every day to be consistent. Well, I know I can't get a hit every day. You know, it's totally impossible. Nobody's ever done that. But I give it my best.
Regardless of what number this is going to be, are you happy that you've sort of kind of picked up again?
Well, it's just. I don't know. I don't get caught up into it because I have no control over it. I prepare myself each day the same way. Same. You know, it's a media thing. The media builds it up a lot bigger than what it is. We have no control except it's our own destiny. We don't know what's going to happen because there's the guy on the mound is getting paid a lot of money to get us out. It's not going to set us on, the ball on a tee for us. So we know that. You know, you're playing the game with these guys.
Can you say that not
I have fun every day. I put a uniform on and take this ever since I played in 86. How can you not have fun? Millions of kids that love to play this game, and I'm lucky enough to do it.
Brian?
And I gotta work even harder to do what I'm doing right now. It's is the level I'm at. It's the level that I got to keep up.
Anyway, you wish you were back to Oakland and
I'm sure, but you know, hey, what can you do? Yeah. They have a whole new team, a different team than when I was playing there. I look at the scoreboard all the time. I'm excited. I got a couple friends on the team that I talk to weekly. I'm happy for
them. Are you surprised that yourself and Sam are back at the same point as last year? On the same pace?
There's no pace. I think the pace is, you know, the only thing is the next home run. I don't look too far ahead. I look at the ninth game. That's about it. You know, it's a media thing. People want to project everything. So, you know, projections are only good. I have no control over it.
Last year you said you were exhausted at the end of the 20 set your 70 home run record. Is it exhausting this year? Or?
Year's not over yet. I'll let you know after the year's over.
About 6 weeks. You can lead a man over here. I just like back. I don't mind.
Well, I've always had media anywhere I've gone. I just got to the forefront this last year because of what happened. You changed history. The fans love it. You know, you get more people out to the ballpark and they enjoy it. So, yeah. I don't quite understand what you're trying to get at. Well, everybody wants to play this. Who doesn't? You know, as anybody that puts on any athletic uniform wants to. Why else would we put on a uniform? I don't play for individual. That just happens. You play between the lines to win. And whatever you do to prepare yourself that day to help chip in and hopefully win that ball game. That's all any individual can ever ask of each other. So, baseball is the hardest thing to do, is to win. 6 months straight, 162 ball games. No other sport doesn't do that. So, I sort of wish it was like hockey, where there's only like five teams that don't go to the playoffs. I mean, it's great for baseball. It has nothing to do with how I'm there. Doesn't change the way I prepare. What I have to do is pick up the ball and try to hit it. The fact is they come to the ballpark and they're excited to come. It's good for us and good for baseball.
Actually, last year I was in Atlanta. I saw Atlanta play the Rams.
He's awesome. I wish you guys were talking more about him. He's probably one of the best young talents in the game. Nobody knows.
Playing on this team.
Speed, power, cannon for an arm.
It wasn't even a game.
27 game head streak. Pure talent. So it's a shame that not many more people are not here to watch him play.
You're talking about preparation. How do you prepare for the home
run? You know.
It just seems so natural.
God gives you a talent, and I use it to the best of my ability.
Yesterday,
you need to be in
the first
draft
in 6 years.
It's like you had to talk
about that a whole lot.
And I'm not
going to
think about it.
That's
what I think about.
Is that
going to
happen?
Is
one of you guys
going to
be there?
There's a chance.
Were you old enough to see any old home run derbies when you used to have it on the TV with Frank Howard and all that?
I didn't see it, but I've seen him replay it on the end.
Does this remind you in all of that, the dual kind of aspect?
Well, there's no comparison to it. There was a pre-stage guy throwing BP.
Yeah.
This isn't BP out there. No. You know, so it's, what we're doing is not easy. You know, it's not easy. It's just, we work hard. Preparation, concentration, that's, you know. If it was easy, a lot more people would be doing it, and they're not.
It looks so easy. I was in Boston. It looks so easy.
It's not.
I know it's not. You make it look easy.
There is nothing in this world that's easy, believe me.
Sammy's made us rush anyway.
Why should you be surprised? I don't know why anybody's surprised.
one thing in particular that you've proven?
By a full extension.
What's the effect of the tournament for the Scotland ball?
You know what? I've been analyzing what it's going to take. You need to talk to our GM and manager about that. Me as a player, I've gotten used to where it's, it doesn't help when players sit there and talk about what needs to be done. We're not in a position to do that. I'm not paid to do that.
I'm going to hustle and come over here and try and help them do it.
Well, let's look at the fact that...
Can I have your bat?
Not many teams get to go to the playoffs, so not many teams. There's a lot of players that don't win. And I've been on a lot of winning teams. You know, so it's not easy to do what we do at this level. You know, so I think the best person to talk about is Ernie Banks. I don't think he ever went to the playoffs, did he? So. You know, a lot of the great players in the game never went to playoffs every year, so I mean, it's not easy.
Mark, 93 and 94, you had 9 home runs each year, injuries late. Does that seem like a long ways off now?
Yep. It is a long ways. Yep.
Did you come close to hanging up back then, or?
That's well documented, yes.
I think in an unusual way that missing those 2 years might have helped you in the long run as far as being able to serve the game a little bit.
I've spent that time and time again, of course, yeah. Cool stuff.
Did you surprise yourself on that opposite field, the length of the opposite field homer yesterday? Did you have to adjust to catch you away more?
You know, he's caught as a young kid, he hit where it fits, right? So, yeah, I was surprised it went that far. Yeah. Like too many people have said MCI doesn't do a good job of measuring everybody except the first. Come to first basis and they mismeasured it.
How have you done here in the past?
Okay. Yeah.
I still find it, when you mentioned it, that the longest one, right, you hit the opposite way. Surprising that there would be something that would still surprise you. You know, that, do you still do things you kind of go, oh, Jesus, I don't believe I did that, or I'm God.
Why not? I mean, you can never take anything for granted in this game. You can never figure out this game. And nothing's ever easy. Nothing's ever easy in this game, believe me.
Excited about watching this
kid. Yep.
What impressions from spring training do you have?
I didn't really see him pitch that much in spring training, so I don't know. But it's just this is just another level. So this is a level that's not comparable to the minor league. So it's going to be exciting to watch him pitch.
Mark.
The place lights up. Stands come alive as Mark McGuire steps in at 6:09 on this 23rd day of August. He bunts the first one, as is the usual routine. That's his bunting practice. Now he'll take a couple of upswings. And his first pitch is in off the wall, off the sign. That's when it hits the top of the batting cage. Gave that first one a ride, but it hit off the Milwaukee Braves sign out left field. A lot of these that hit off the top of the batting cage would probably just be routine fly balls. It's a line shot that will not reach, reaches a fence on a bounce. There's one that the fans will get a chance at. And another one right behind it. That one is way, way back there, way back there. Look out. Shot. That's going to curve foul, but it's way back there. That would have been a foul ball. Nothing foul about that one. Almost hit the roof. And the fans are eating it up. Fans are eating it up. I don't know if that landed in the upper deck or exactly where that ball went to. McGuire back in. Pop up to short center field. Could be deep enough. Could be deep enough. It is. A lot of gloves out there in that left field area. Now Matt will come back in very quickly here. Tries to give one to the right field fans. Off the wall, off the wall. This one's going to be foul, but way back there, way, way back there. And it looks like McGuire is throwing the ball on the stands. He's had his batting practice. Let's see, he's not going to sign. Maybe he'll come back out and sign later. He's been pretty good in the previous trips here about signing for the youngsters. He headed right into the dugout. Leadoff hitter has walked in. That'll bring up Mr. Mark McGuire. There's Mike Dowd, and there's Mark McGuire. Those of you who thought they were the same people. A rare shot of the two of them in the same picture. J.D. Drew at the plate. Mark McGuire will lead off the top of the third, his team leading 3-0.
First baseman Mark McGuire.
Hitting 287. Cardinals pick up another run to make it 4. And Drew at bat, McGuire on deck.
I'd like to show this on the center fielder, J.D. Drew.
Two outs now. Mark McGuire, 96, 52 homers, 97, 58 homers, 98, all-time record of 70 this year. On August 23rd, he's at center field. This could be 51. Looks like he has room. Hit it to the deepest part of the park. Didn't quite get it all. McGuire on deck in the top of the seventh. set.
Il y a pas toujours de gauche, c'est toujours de rain.
Pay the bills. And
well, that's the parking is not owned by the Expos. It's the Olympic Stadium facility that handles the parking.
Yeah, well, then they make money off the people.
Mark McGuire, what do you know about this guy?
Well, his career has been interesting. Would you agree? Now, here's Mark McGuire. Started out with a splash. Kabing, kabang.
49 homers.
Yes. I mean, he was a big home run hitter early on. Was it 87 or 88, something like that. Oh, and the forearms, that their power is really generated by those strong forearms. That's the way Steve Garvey was. Big, strong.
Popeye.
Yes, strong forearms. So I'm starting to work on that. I'm squeezing tennis balls, and I've decided that I'm going to strengthen my forearms for whatever I might be able to do.
Well, milking cows is good for that, too.
I don't want to do that too much. I'm not good at that. I tried that once at Joe Giroux's farm, and I quit.
Yeah, that's like Hank Aaron. He always said it was in his wrist. The quickness of his wrist is what gave him the home run power. The noise volume goes up a little bit when Big Mac steps in. The attention is all focused on Mark McGuire as he steps into the batting cage. Mike Leisler has stepped in. He's been talking to this guy about his theory on how McGuire gets his power into the ball. Now he's going to show him here. It's a fly ball to right center, shallow right center. Straight away center, it's back. It's gone. That one is crushed. Into outer reaches. There's another one that nobody's going to catch. This one looks playable. A line shot this time. He's handing out souvenirs tonight. Nice catch there. And McGuire gets a nice round of applause. He'll be back in just a moment. I think the Drakes and the Gagnons were duly impressed there with Mark McGuire. Drive. Got his line drive swing down there. That's it. I don't know if that's deep enough. All of a sudden he's lost his home run swing. Maybe he's saving him for the game.
Oh, geez, I missed him.
With one out and J.D. Drew at the plate, Mark McGuire is on deck in the first inning. McGuire was 2-for-5 last night. Comes into the game batting 287. McGuire will step up there with one on and one out.
A 2-1 home run, Mark
gone. J.D. Drew at the plate. And one out. The plate could only mean one thing, Mark. McGuire is on deck for the fourth time in the ballgame.
All my impressions of all that stuff mean a lot when I'm retired. I have a lot playing with. That's about it. There's no time to reflect on that. So I got a few more years to play.
We asked Tony Gwynn like the same question before his game where he hit his 3,000. Mm-hmm. You know, do you go into this game thinking, wow, this game I could...
I don't even know. I don't even know who's next. I don't really care. It has no bearing on what I do that day. I'm paid to play the game. I'm not paid to look at history. So that's the way I look at things. Sorry if I don't please your mood yet.
Curveball?
Curveball, yeah. Curveball and reacted to it. So...
When Guerrero extended his streak first base, mm-hmm. did you have to tell him to
stay? Yeah. I said, tip your hat. You know, he deserves it. Why not? I mean, they don't get much fan support up here, and they have probably one of the best players in the game, which is sad that fans up here don't come out to watch him. He's a very exciting player. He's got a 29-game hitting streak now. And they stood on their feet. I don't know how many people were there today, and he deserves it. So I asked him, I said, tip your hat. He deserves it. He's one hell of a player. So I get excited to watch him play.
He's terribly shy. Was he a bit reluctant?
I think everybody's shy about that. You know, it's tough. But, what I've dealt with the last couple of years, there's a time and a place where you can tip your hat. And the fans stood and clapping for, about a minute. And I said, this is what they want. So. He needed it, so I'm glad he did it.
Being the team guy that you've said it all along, it must be tough for you to talk about the individual stuff the day after.
I never have. You guys talk about it more than I do.
Or being asked about it, that's the thing.
Well, I don't know why you guys ask about it. I do what I can each day to help the team win, and it's I don't know how much more I can emphasize as a team game. Individual accomplishments are only good when the season's over and when you're retired. This game is difficult, but I work very, very hard at it, and I do my best every day. I go home and look at my mirror and say that I gave the best every day. All right.
All the success he's had, he's also had some frustrating seasons, and the last two seasons are an example of that. And if you go back to the early 90s, he had 2 years in a row when he had only 9 home runs. And many fans tend to forget about that if they ever knew it to begin with, that he had some seasons where he thought very seriously about quitting.
Only 9 home runs? I don't remember. Wow.
2 very injury-plagued years. And, of course, the old saying always was with McGuire that if he ever stays healthy for an entire year, look out.
Yeah, because they actually, he played with Canseco, right?
Yeah,
and
with Oakland, yeah.
And he was always Canseco would put in more time, but McGuire's numbers were just as good with the limited amount of time that he put in.
And he suddenly got hot a few years back, and right in the middle of that season, Oakland traded him to St. Louis. He ended up with 58 home runs for the season. But, as the old saying goes, you ain't seen nothing yet. And
they've got, they're in a wicked playoff race. There's three teams, Arizona, Los Angeles, San Francisco, all bundled up together.
Well, I think one thing, Bill, I'm a couple days older than you, so I remember 1961 when Roger Maris and Mickey Mantle were going head-to-head and Maris hit the 60-run home runs. A big factor to the fans liking Mantle more was that Mantle had the reputation. He'd been there a lot more years and had hit a lot more home runs. Maris had a successful season in 1960 as that one error gets over the in the bleachers, halfway up to the bleachers, and almost dead center. So right on his tail. And the most he's ever hit in a single season, and he's been around 10 or 12 seasons, is 31 homers. So I think you find the fans cheering for the guy who has the reputation. So I think that's why this year more people are pulling for Bonds and Gonzalez. And when McGuire did it, more people were pulling for him than with Sosa. Any thoughts on that? You're a man of many thoughts.
Bonds is not that popular, though.
I know that, but you don't really, I think...
The ball. You know? And the one thing about Bonds, you know, that a lot of people remember about him is... There's a shot. Is that he has not...
I think we might see one. Well, he's swinging right now. We might see one tonight. I'm going to have to make sure either you or Nick are down here to...
That's either the third or fourth time he's hit one out right here in bat practice. Well, what I was going to say about Bonds is that he's choked in the playoffs. You know, he's hit a lot of home runs. He's been a great guy during the regular seasons, but that's one thing that's going against him, I think, a little bit.
McGuire, the times we've seen come down here, McGuire's been very good about signing autographs for the fans.
And that's one thing that keeps you popular. You know, if you work hard and actually take the time out for the fans. I don't care what ball player you are, you're gonna remain popular with the fans.
And he's very good about it. Getting back to the Bonds, the interviews that I have seen, he's given a lot of credit to God. He says, you know, God gives me these hot streaks, and he says I've asked God, he said, why not give me a hot streak in the playoffs? He says, not at the start of the season. He says, I'd like to get a hot streak in October instead of in May or June. So, you know, anytime for me when a superstar athlete like that is man enough to admit that maybe God has a lot to do with his success, I that impresses me.
I haven't heard them interviews. You know, I don't know. Sometimes watching SportsCenter and everything can get a little monotonous.
Yeah, and it interferes with your Cartoon Network, I know.
Yeah.
You wouldn't know what Yosemite Sam is up to, would you?
That's right, your rack and frack environment.
Okay, well, I think Nick's arm is about to fall off. He thought he was... he had a good arm.
You know.
Well, the season's over. In case you haven't heard, Bill, the season is over.
If you hear Calvin go, ouch, or something, I just kicked him in the ankle.
But we'll let Nick wrap up this portion, and then we'll be back with some game clips, and maybe we'll...